Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our 8th grade promotion ceremony. Would you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. We would like to thank all of you for being here to celebrate with us tonight. Friends, family, teachers, board members, Superintendent Shuttler, Ms. Haverty, we appreciate your support. At this time, I'd like to introduce our principal, Ms. Ann Haverty.
Very proud moment for all of you sitting out in the audience to see these 8th graders being promoted to start the new journey to high school. And I would like to take a moment to thank some very important people to make this possible. First and foremost would be Ms. Dougherty, 8th grade ELA teacher. Along with her is Ms. Amy Vavroff, Ms. Lisa Clark, Mr. Farrell, Mr. Gary Wickerson, who helped with the backdrop, Mr. Davenport, who helped with the video, and all the middle school staff that helped these kids progress from, and elementary, I see a lot of elementary teachers out there too, that progress from kindergarten, preschool, clear up through 8th grade, and now are heading forward into high school. Thank you, and enjoy your kids' promotion.
At this time, I'd like to introduce our superintendent, Mr. Zach Shuttler.
Thank you. Jordan, well, it's pretty appropriate that you're introducing me because I have a story that's about you. Don't get too nervous, though. It's a good one. It's a good one. About a month ago, I received an email from Jordan, and he was requesting to interview me. I believe it was for Mrs. Dougherty's class, an assignment. And so I opened up the email, and of course I would grant that interview. And I thought I'd be answering questions about, you know, what's my favorite sports team, or what's my favorite food, or something very superficial. But then I clicked on the attachment, and some of the questions that he was asking, it was going to require a lot of thought from me. And here's some of those questions. What could we do to improve our curriculum? Yeah, pretty deep. Are there any classes that you think that should be taught in the school that are not being taught that could help us when we're adults? Yeah. What could we do to improve our collaboration skills with our classmates? And finally, this is the one that really forced me to step back and think, do you think school systems are actually useful? So this wasn't, you know, what's my favorite topping on a pizza type interview. This was a legit interview. I felt like I was going in to be on 2020 or something like that. So I was a little nervous. But of course I responded back. I said, absolutely, Jordan, I'll sit down with you. And you know, we arrived and he handled it like a professional. He had his iPad set up and he filmed it and he asked the questions just like he were a reporter. And it really hit me. It was one of the highest moments of my year that what he was doing is exactly what we want all of our students to be doing. He had a sense of voice. He had a sense of agency. He was going to change things in the school, and he wasn't changing them by himself. He was changing them with his teacher. The reason why I share that story is not to embarrass Jordan. I share that story because everyone on this stage has a huge, huge opportunity in front of them. Your teachers and your administrators would love, and I mean that, they would love to work with you together to help improve the school and address all of those questions that you raised. I know not all of you probably feel that way. Some of you probably look at the next 4 years as a giant obstacle that's in your path, maybe a giant boulder that you have to get through to do what you really, really want to do. And that exists for everybody. At all points in your life, there will be obstacles in your way. When I think about obstacles, and I think about overcoming them, I think about a specific quote from the Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius. He said, "The impediment to action advances action. What stands in the way becomes the way." And most of you are probably nervous and wondering, what the heck is he talking about? And that's a good point. What am I talking about? Well, what that quote means is that things that stand in your way, they're an opportunity to grow and practice and develop a virtue. So when we go about addressing those questions that Morgan posed, how do we make our school a better place? Well, you're going to be collaborating together. And when you collaborate with your partner, and maybe they're late on an assignment, that's an opportunity to practice patience. Maybe in a few years you're in Mr. Hansen's innovation and entrepreneurship class, or maybe Mr. Davenport's multimedia class, and you have to design a business plan, and it fails miserably. That's an opportunity to learn what not to do next time. Maybe you don't take Mrs. Clark's advice, and you do not save your assignment on OneDrive. It's happened to me. That's an opportunity to start over and make your next assignment even better. If a classmate is disrespectful towards you, maybe on social media, that's an opportunity to practice forgiveness. And finally, nobody's going to pretend that the next 4 years are going to be easy. There's going to be a lot of tough things in front of you. All of that is an opportunity to get stronger. The impediment to action advances action. What stands in the way becomes the way. Please use the next 4 years to work with your teachers and your administrators. Learn to lead with them. And use your voice and your ideas to overcome every obstacle that you face. Thank you.
Our first student speaker this evening is Jason Aubrey, who will speak to us about his promise.
Good evening. LeBron James, one of the greatest basketball players of all time, once said, "I promise to never forget where I came from." Well, growing up, LeBron didn't have much of anything, but he was always very talented when it came to basketball. Since reaching the National Basketball Association, he's always remembered the people who supported him and the place that he came from. LeBron has played for three different teams throughout his career, but to him, he'll always just be a kid from Akron, Ohio. While trying to achieve your goals, there will always be people behind you, supporting you and cheering you on. Never forget those people. When it comes to sports, my coaches have always believed in me. I've been yelled at during practices by my dad and Coach Woolland, but it wasn't because they didn't believe in me. It was because they did, and because they wanted me to succeed. Everyone will most likely fail at some time in his or her life, but there are people who will be there to help you learn from your mistakes. Don't listen to people who talk negatively about you. Instead, listen to those who have always had your back. Bridgeport, Ohio will always be my home. As I enter high school, I want to set goals, goals that I hope to achieve before the end of my senior year, before I go out into the world. No matter where I go after high school or who I grow up to be, I will always remember the place that I came from. It's what made me who I am today. Set a goal. Do the best you can to achieve that goal. When you succeed, help others who want to achieve the same goal you've accomplished. Life can take you in many different directions, but never forget the place where you started, the place where you have people who support you. Some will doubt you. Don't listen to anyone who doubts you. Instead, listen to those who support and believe in you. I promise to never forget the people who have always accepted who I am. I promise to always make every effort to be successful. I promise to always make the better choice, the right choice. I promise I will never forget those who spoke negatively or doubted me, because those people made me stronger and forced me to work harder so I could prove them wrong. I will always follow my dreams, but I promise to never forget where I came from. Thank you.
Our second speaker tonight, Jaden Ray, tells us that this time he won't give up.
Thank you. There are infinite number of ways to symmetrically cut a circle, but there's not an infinite amount of time in our lives. This was the beginning of my speech, and I had way more, but it just didn't seem right. But being me, I just gave up. Just wrote something that didn't mean anything to me. But then I thought, no. I've gone through a lot of my life giving up when things get difficult. But this time, I won't give up. I will keep trying. At the start of this year, Ms. Dockery asked that we come up with one word. One word to be something that we work towards. And I didn't know what to do. I thought the words kind, happiness, or friendship. But I landed on try because so many people, myself included, tend to give up when things get difficult. I'm done giving up, done letting myself take the easy way out. Many people give up when things get difficult because it can be easier or take the easy way out rather than face the fear of failure. But failure isn't necessarily a bad thing. Trying is like a sunrise. You can't get to the bright sunlight until after you make it through the darkness of night. You have to endure failure and accept that when you do try, you don't always fail. But that is proof you're trying. And if you continue to try, you can, you will succeed. Trying and failing will always be better than failing to try. If we all just keep trying, even after we fail, we can do great things. When we try our best, that's when we become our best selves. That's when we accomplish our goal. We can't do the things we want by taking the easy way out. Eighth grade is a great year for learning and growing. In a few short months, we will walk through the doors and become high schoolers. And then the time for giving up will be over. We have to try and keep trying. So even if you are someone who has taken the easy way out in the past or given up, just make sure from here on out, you try and you never give up. Because once we stop trying, that's when we truly fail. And that failure is much scarier than trying and failing. Thank you.
The next student to speak this evening will be Emma Bittner, who will talk about the need to believe.
Should always be able to succeed.
I can imagine that you all have been told the same thing.
But do we ever stop to think about it? I know I always think, yeah, right, but I've never stopped to realize what I have been able to accomplish by believing in myself. Most people tell themselves that they're not able to do something. In many cases, it's easier to say, I can't do that, than it is to say, I can at least try. Some will even use that as an excuse. They can't do something because they don't believe in themselves enough to even attempt it. But if you don't attempt it, how will you know the outcome? Personally, I rarely ever believe in myself. There have been multiple circumstances where I have had very little faith. Normally, I would be shocked by answering the test question correct, or maybe by getting a yes after I asked if we could have ice cream. But last summer, I got the biggest surprise yet. I was accepted into a summer program in Hudson, Ohio. I never thought in a million years that I would get accepted. I thought it would end up being a waste of time going to all the meetings. I didn't believe in myself at all, so you can imagine the shock of the great news. But even after being accepted, I wasn't sure if I could do it. I'd never been away from my family before, and I was about to spend 3 weeks with complete strangers while all of my family and friends were almost 3 hours away. I wasn't going to go, but my mom said, if you don't go, I think you'll really, really regret it. I began to think about how lucky I was to be accepted and how unfair it would be for me to not take advantage of the opportunity. In the end, I decided I would go. It turned out to be one of the best experiences of my life. I enjoyed it so much, I even decided to reapply this again this year. I don't expect to make it in, as it is more of a focus for upcoming eighth graders and not ninth, but I would love to go again. I've been able to boost my self-confidence by believing that I can accomplish what I think I can do. As we enter into our first year of high school, may we all remember to believe in ourselves. It will benefit us in many ways, some big and some small, and will allow us to accomplish so much later in life. We should put more faith into ourselves. You never know what good it might do. In the words of Vioda, do or do not, there is no try. Thank you.
Our fourth student speaker tonight is Jaden Coons, who will discuss Better Us.
To become the best you that you can be, you must have many qualities, most of which a leader shows. The main characteristics that we all need to have are respect, responsibility, caring, citizenship, fairness, and trustworthiness. There are more characteristics that you need to have to be even better. Those include perseverance, confidence, honesty, and loyalty. Before you can show most of these qualities, you have to be able to trust yourself. Most of us, including myself, struggle with this. We doubt ourselves and don't think that we can do something that seems too hard. Then somebody, or maybe even ourselves, convinces us to try it, and we find out it is as hard as we thought. In the same way, we all try and search for a greater meaning to life. We ask ourselves things like, why am I here, and who am I? I'm not here to answer these questions that anyone you ask in this very room has probably wondered about. Each of us needs to find our own answer to these questions. That's what makes us who we are. You are who you want to be. Don't let other people define who you are. Sometimes that's difficult, though. You might feel confused and alone. But although it might seem like you're alone, there are many people who have experienced and are currently experiencing what you're going through. Always remember that you are not alone. You will always have someone who can lift you up and make you feel better. I know, sometimes it is hard to find those people, but there is always someone who can help you. It may take a while to find them, but it is worth it. They will make you feel better. We have all been knocked down, pushed around, and rejected. But guess what? That's not the end. Actually, that's just the beginning. We must get back up and fight. If it's a bully who won't leave you alone, ignore him, and sooner or later he will stop. If it's a family problem, then you have to talk about it. You can't stay down. Don't ever stay down. Don't let other people define who you are. You are who you want to be. Don't let anybody change that. Thank you.
The next speaker this evening is Kyle Kearns, who will talk about The Ones Who Will Stay.
Someone to help them throughout their life. Somebody should always be there to teach us life skills like cooking and cleaning. When we have our tough times, there will always be somebody to cheer us up. I hope every one of us in this room has that person in his or her life. Throughout my life on this spherical earth, there has been one person with whom I have been countless things together. That somebody for me is my mother's boyfriend, Scott. I've known Scott for many, many long and aggravating years. From the first time I ever remember seeing him, we never got along. We always bickered and made fun of each other, but deep, deep down, in the darkest caverns of our souls, I knew we loved each other. We always go golfing together and we ride around in the golf carts like race cars. He's the person who taught me how to cook. Sometimes he's strict, but he just wants me to grow up a good kid. And I know we will always have our ups and downs, but God's like a father to me. No, wait. He is a father to me. When he's doing various things, like remodeling or working on his car, you can almost always find me standing behind him, spectating. We all need that person in our lives to always look up and strive to be like. They should support you through your toughest times. That person should be an inspiration in your life. Once again, that person for me is Scott. He has his flaws, but doesn't everybody? Just because he makes a few mistakes doesn't mean I should give up on him. When those people can't be there for you sometimes, they'll still think about you. They'll make mistakes from time to time, but you should forgive them. They've looked out for you, so give them another chance. One day, we'll just look out back on the situation and laugh. Thank you, Scott, Jackson, and even though you have your quirky flat earth theories, you're still the loving father I never had. I'm proud to call Scott Jackson, right there in the Nike hat. thank you to Scott and all the other people like him who helped all of us through this rough journey called life. Stick with them because, as people,
you know who you are.
Have told me, they are the ones who will stay. Thank you.
Our final eighth grade speaker tonight is Madison Criswell, who will share with us her thoughts about change. It's hard to believe that in a few short months, we'll officially be high schoolers. It seems like we just started middle school. Throughout the years, there have been many changes. Big changes, like getting new teachers or adding onto the school. Small changes, like hallway decorations or round tables in Ms. Doherty's class. Big or small, almost all the changes have been positive and has helped us grow as individuals. At the beginning of the year in Ms. Doherty's class, we had to write a paragraph about how we can leave things better than we found them. When I heard that Mr. Shuttler was stepping down as superintendent, I immediately thought of this. For the few years that Mr. Shuttler has been at Bridgeport, he has changed things for the better. He has encouraged teachers to implement fun learning activities like Soul into the classrooms. Things like this make school more enjoyable. It is noticeable to us students that Mr. Shuttler has been very supportive of the teachers. Because of this, teachers have been able to teach freely and try new things. More than that, though, he interacts with the students and treats us all the same. Because the superintendent takes time to notice us, it makes us feel empowered to take more of a leadership role. He will be leaving our middle school better than he found it. Even though we're teenagers who are seen as immature and irresponsible, we can still do plenty to make things better. We can start off by doing small things in the school and in the community. Maybe even one day we could do things to change the world. I know that sounds crazy, but we all have the ability to leave things better than we found them. Thank you.
Our guest speaker this evening is Miss Caitlin Cole, a 2016 graduate of Bridgeport High School. While at Bridgeport, Caitlin served as the senior class president, was on the homecoming court, and graduated in the top five of her class. Miss Cole was a standout in softball, but excelled in basketball. She is the all-time leading scorer, males and females, in Bridgeport history, with 2,130 points, despite an injury that ended her high school career her senior year. And she is the fifth female to score 2,000 points in the OVAC. While at Bridgeport, Caitlin was selected to the All-Ohio team, was named Eastern Player of the Year, and received numerous other accolades. She is currently fourth in the all-time Ohio State record books for most free throws made in a season and in a career, and fifth for most steals in a career. She is also listed twice for the most free throws made in a game, and is listed for highest free throw percentage in a season and in a career. Miss Cole began her college career at St. Francis University, where she was named the NEC Rookie of the Year and made the NEC All-Conference team. She was also a member of the NEC Conference championship team that played the UConn Huskies in the NCAA tournament. In 2018, Caitlin transferred to Ohio University, where she will continue her basketball career with the Bobcats. Throughout her college career, Caitlin has been on the Dean's List. She will graduate in the fall of 2020 with degrees in accounting, business, pre-law, and business pre-law. She aspires to be a CPA. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back my sister, Caitlin Cole. Oh.
Students, parents, faculty, and administration, good evening and congratulations to the Bridgeport Bulldogs 8th grade graduating class of 2019. I'd like to thank Ms. Doherty for inviting me back to my alma mater as your guest speaker. I feel I should be an expert at this by now, but that's not truly accurate. 7 years ago, I was in the same auditorium representing my 8th grade graduating class as one of the speakers. 3 years ago, I spoke at my high school graduation as well as to the 8th grade graduating class of 2016. But this year especially, it's an honor and a privilege to be here as my family and I recognize my little brother, Jaden. Once I accepted Ms. Dougherty's invitation, I pondered what message I wanted to relay to all of you. I wanted to be different, share something new with you, since some of you may have heard me speak previously. However, the message I wanted to convey was always the same, just written differently. Therefore, this evening, I would like to share my personal story with you in hopes that even if I inspire only one student, then my message was effective. For as long as I can remember, I've had a basketball in my hands, but I've been playing organized basketball since the second grade. Over the years, my love for the game grew. I was in middle school when I decided I wanted to play Division I basketball. In sixth grade, two local coaches hand-selected eight girls to form the Lady Rebels AAU basketball team. For the next 4 years, this team became family. We traveled all over the East Coast to play and were insanely successful. I remember at one point we had won 44 straight games. In seventh grade, we competed at AAU Nationals in Tennessee and placed fourth in the nation. Unfortunately, the team disbanded after my freshman year of high school as interest among the group changed and I had to find a new team. As you all know, I'm a 2016 graduate of Bridgeport High School and was a four-year member of the Lady Bulldogs basketball team. During my freshman and sophomore years, I was fortunate to play with two teammates who shared the same passion I had for basketball. We changed the program around and went 44-5 my first 2 years. After they graduated, there was speculation as to how the team would fare with 2,000 point scorers gone. The burden was on my shoulders and I was up for the challenge. My junior year, we finished 21-3. But let me take a step back for a moment. Remember, I was in middle school when I decided I wanted to play college basketball. People doubted me and my abilities. I was told I wasn't tall enough, fast enough, athletic enough, and even told by a Division I coach that I didn't score enough. I was told the school I attended was too small and the competition I played was too weak. I often wondered if my dreams were even unattainable. Rather than give up, I worked even harder. I told myself I may fail, but I refused to fail to try. In order to be recruited, it's imperative you play on a travel basketball team and compete at NCAA-sanctioned tournaments to gain exposure. My parents and I decided it would be in my best interest to compete with a team from Columbus. This meant long days of traveling for practice, incorporating additional workouts on my own, and scheduling 6 a.m. summer workouts with a trainer. Through it all, I had unconditional support, love, and guidance from my family. I'm going to sidetrack a moment to emphasize family. My family sacrificed a lot in helping my dream become a reality. 1 week after I graduated high school, I moved into my first college dormitory. I understand my situation is different than most college students in that my time at home is very limited. I don't receive the standard summer and Christmas breaks that others do. However, this was my choice and the price I pay so that I could continue to play the game I love at the next level. Although I was excited to be grown and on my own, I didn't realize just how much I would miss my family. Prior to college, my family never missed a game, yet when in college and you are traveling the entire United States, it's impossible for them to be present at every game. Although they might not be physically in the stands for every game, now I know they are with me always, at home, in front of the TV, cheering me on. Parents, be there for your children. And children, respect and appreciate all your parents do and sacrifice for you. Make time for each other, as tomorrow isn't promised to anyone. I promise you, it means more than you think. But back to my story. The summer before my senior year, I verbally committed to play Division I basketball for St. Francis University. It was like a weight had been lifted from my shoulders. I was excited and couldn't wait to begin my senior season and be able to just play. I didn't have to worry about impressing the college coaches that were sitting in the stands that traveled far and near to see me play. It was a relief. In November of 2015, I officially signed my national letter of intent to play at St. Francis University, and just a few days later began my senior year. The season was going better than anyone expected, and we were 16-3. I became the all-time leading scorer, I surpassed 2,000 career points, and they were both personal goals I set for myself long before. However, on February 4th, 2016, 9 seconds into the second quarter of the OVAC game against Wheeling Central, I went up for a routine layup, and as I came down, I felt a pop. I fell to the ground, screaming in pain and tears running down my face. I tore my ACL, and my high school basketball days were over.
I struggled with why this had to happen to me. In all my years of playing, I never missed a game. I couldn't comprehend, or maybe I didn't want to, but why? Why me? Why did this injury have to happen? I still had games to play, records to achieve, and a team, coaches, and a community that I didn't want to let down. I underwent my first knee surgery in March of 2016, and my second surgery, including a full leg cast days before my high school graduation in May of 2016. The rehabilitation process was long and brutal. There were days I wanted to give up. I was tired of hearing the same questions. Will you be able to play basketball again? Will this affect your scholarship? And do you think you'll ever be the same? I was redshirted in my freshman year at St. Francis as I continued to heal. In February of 2017, I was finally cleared by the surgeon to resume all basketball activities. After 21 months, in November of 2017, I played in my first basketball game since the injury. I'll admit, I was nervous. I was scared of re-injuring my leg. However, with each passing game, I became more confident in myself and my abilities, and the fear of injury is a distant memory. My first year playing Division I basketball, I started every game. It was named an NEC Rookie of the Year. After a successful season at SFU, I made the difficult decision to transfer to Ohio University. I had a sit out this past year due to NCAA transfer rules and also had hip surgery in December to repair a torn hip labrum. Just last week, I was once again cleared to resume full basketball activities. I'm anxious to begin my chapter at Ohio University. But my message to you is to dream big. When one says you can't, prove that you can. Make your dream your reality with dedication, discipline, and perseverance. This is true in academics, athletics, and every aspect of your life. My brother has dreams of attending Stanford University upon graduation. Jaden, chase those dreams and make them your reality. I'm proof to each one of you graduating the eighth grade today that anything is possible. I'm just a girl from the small town of Bridgeport that had a dream and is now living the reality. Basketball is my life and my first love. In life, we will all be faced with obstacles, but it's how we overcome those obstacles that defines us. Remember earlier when I said I went through a stage where I didn't understand why it all had to happen? Well, I'm here to tell you I finally understand. There are times in all of our lives that we take people and things for granted. Every minute I'm on the court, I cherish it and embrace it because I know in an instant it can be taken away from me. Every minute I have with my family, I cherish and embrace it because I know tomorrow I'll be hours away from them. God only gives his strongest battles to his toughest soldiers, and you better believe that I'm back stronger than I ever was. Don't give up. Tough times don't last, but tough people do. You all are Bulldog strong. You all will succeed, and I wish you the best. Thank you.
Time, the Bridgeport Board of Education, myself, and Mr. Shuttler will be promoting eighth graders to their high school career. Row one, please stand. Emma Lee Pittner. Jaden Alexander Ray. Jason Jonathan Aubrey. Connor Warren Audi. Logan Michael Martin. Jordan Paul Morgan. Row one, you may be seated. Row two, please stand. Mason Allen at Aberts. Ashlyn Nicole Allen. Kaylee Rose Bain. Kirsten Elizabeth Barsh. Cadence Michelle Bell. Joseph Carmelo Bugai. Corinne Justine Cantor. Lillian Marie Cantor. Alexis Storm Clemens. Jacob Richard Cunningham. Kyle Alexander Dunlap. Row two, please be seated. Row three, please stand. Emmy Marie Felton. Addison Bear Bologna. Austin Michael Gunnell. Natalie Lynn Garcia. Kristen William Garcia. Yeah. Braden LaShawn Green. Kanye Josiah Green. Jacob Allen Gregory. Rihanna Alexis Hall. Jacob Michael Hython. Colin Matthew Jackson. Row three, you may be seated. Row 4, please stand. Riley Jolynn Kinney. Brinley Mae McConaughey. Jaden Trey Palmer. Gabrielle Elizabeth Perchetti. Peyton Andrew Pyle. Justice Marie Rattay. Kayla Marie Reba. Chandler Allen Rice. Gavin Jeffrey Roberts. Alexis Leanne Rubel. Quinn Keller Stopski. Octaviana Ronan Saldana. Row 4, please be seated. Row 5, please stand. Deja Wesley Smith. Tyler Bryce Snodgrass. Daniel George Spurlock Jr. Shailen Marie Stearns.
Freshman, it's kind of a pivotal moment in my experience, when you change from a kindergartner to a first grader, second grader, and so forth. But there's a big change when you change from an eighth grader to a freshman, and then you're a sophomore, and then you're a junior, and then you're a senior. Those are pivotal times in your life. And I would like to share, I've always relished the love of reading, and it started when my boys were born, and our Savor the Books for a very long time. Parents and guardians and visitors, you will see them play on the screen above while I read to the kids. I wish you more. I wish you more ups than downs. I wish you more give than take. I wish you more tippy toes than knees. I wish you more weed than me. I wish you more hugs than hugs. I wish you more wahoos than. I wish you more will than a hill. I wish you more can than not. I wish you more snowflakes than tongue. I wish you more pause than fast forward. I wish you more umbrella than rain. I wish you more bubbles than bath. I wish you more treasures than pockets. I wish you more stories than stars. I wish all of this for you, because you are everything we could wish for.
At this time, we would like to once again thank Caitlin Kroll for sharing her thoughts with us this evening. We wish her the very best as she begins her senior year at Ohio University. We would also like to express our gratitude to Mrs. Marilyn Daler for once again returning to help us out with the alma mater. Please accept the flowers on the piano as a token of that appreciation.
A few weeks ago, I asked Mr. Shetler to do an interview for me for my 8th grade ELA project on the state of education today. Of course he agreed. He spent about 40 minutes answering every one of my questions. He talked to me like I was a grown-up and was kind and encouraging the whole time. He did this knowing that in just 3 days, he would be announcing to the staff that he is stepping down. I was shocked when I heard the news. I couldn't believe that he could do the whole interview with me and not let on that anything was wrong. But that's how Mr. Shelter is. He does his best to make every student feel important and every teacher feel empowered to do what's best for the students. We don't always know everything that our teachers do to plan our lessons, but we do know that there's been a change since Mr. Shelter was with us. We are trying new strategies in classrooms, we are collaborating with our peers, and we are learning how to be leaders. We want you to know that you are leading the school district, the staff, the students, and the community better than you found it.
That is success. You have succeeded. Each week, Mr. Shetler sends the teachers a quote. Following his example, I found one that matches him. If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader, John Quincy Adams. Thank you for leading our tribe, Mr. Shetler. We will miss you.
The journey along the road of our middle school years has been one of uncertain steps and long loops, of twists and turns and constant strides. And now, we face the next road, one that is wider and steeper and more challenging than the one we leave behind, yet is lined with opportunities and excitement. This evening's promotion ceremony celebrates our completion of middle school. Our first act as Bridgeport High School students will be the singing of the alma mater, led by Madison Criswell and Addison Delonia, and accompanied by Mrs. Marilyn Daler on the piano. Would everyone please stand and join us?
Future class of 2023.